Hello viewers, today I would like to talk about the Key Fob, which is one of my favorite comfort features in any car. This little thing allows you to lock the car or roll the windows from a distance, which is excellent in many cases. Truth be told, you might not be aware of how Key Fobs are helpful until it stops working. This is also when you'll realize that resetting or replacing it is not a simple job. So, in this video, we will explain how the Key Fob works and, more importantly, what to do when you have a faulty one. But before we do that, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification button to stay in touch with all the latest automotive content on our channel. The Key Fob works on a simple principle. When you press one of its buttons, it transmits a signal in a microwave form. On the other side, the car has a receiver which picks up the signal, assuming the distance between it and the Key Fob is not too large. With the signal received, the car automatically does what it is supposed to do, like unlocking the doors, rolling the windows, or popping up the trunk. This is something that differs depending on the car and its trim level. But now, here comes the tricky part. Just like the key has to match the keyhole it unlocks, so does the Key Fob's frequency has to match the car. In simple words, the car will only recognize and respond to the signal from its Key Fob and no others. Otherwise, anybody with a Key Fob could unlock your car and steal it. And because the Key Fob has to be paired up with the car, replacing it is not easy as with some other parts. Basically, when you get a new Key Fob or want to reset one that stopped working, you'll have to teach it to speak the language of the car, so to say. This means programming all the right signals and frequencies into it. Sure, you may go to the dealer for this, but it will almost certainly cost you an arm and a leg for something that usually can be done without any special equipment or tools. So now that you know the theory behind the Key Fobs, let's take a look at how you can program the Key Fobs by yourself. The procedure is, in most cases, really easy, and all you have to do is follow these few simple steps. For a start, if your Key Fob just stopped working, maybe its battery is dead. In that case, before doing anything else, replace the battery, especially if you haven't done so in a while. A bad battery can give you a real headache while trying to reprogram the Key Fob. On the other hand, these batteries are usually cheap and easy to replace, so it's definitely worth doing this. But where the battery is located within the Key Fob and how it's replaced differs depending on the car. The best way to find this out is by checking your owner's manual, or if you don't have it, you can always leave us a question here or at our community forum. Next, get in the driver's seat with your car keys and any fobs you want to reprogram and close all the doors. Closing all the doors is an important step here, as leaving any of them open will usually disrupt the process. Once seated, insert the key into the ignition and turn it to the on position. This is the one that illuminates the dashboard and powers up all electrical systems. However, don't turn the engine while doing this. With the key in the on position, press the fob's lock button and turn the key back to the off position. Repeat this process 3 times at least, ending the cycle with the key in the on position once again. By doing so, you'll actually tell your car to start the Key Fob programming. At this point, the car's control module sends a set of specific signals to the Key Fob, which saves it for the future usage. Or to put it simply, you're teaching the Key Fob now how to communicate with the car. After repeating the above process, you should hear the doors lock. This is a good sign, as it shows that your car has entered the programming mode and that the procedure is successful so far. When you hear the doors lock, press the lock button on your Key Fob once again within 5 seconds and the programming should be completed successfully. So, with the first Key Fob successfully paired up, you can now do any additional ones if you have them. To do this, press the lock button within the 10 seconds after entering programming mode to program those remotes as well. You could also try to press the lock or unlock button at the same time as you program the primary remote when turning the ignition in the beginning to get a successful result. Once all the steps are performed and you got the successful signal from all the Key Fobs you wanted to program, turn the ignition back to the off position. This, in effect, terminates the programming procedure. In the end, take all the Key Fobs you programmed with you and leave the vehicle and close all the doors. Test both the unlock and lock function with all of your Key Fobs that have been programmed to verify the functionality. But if the Key Fobs still don't work, or only one of them works, you may want to try the whole process once again. And of course, there is always a chance that this method will not work on your car and model.
Okay, so that's Key Fob programming explained in 8 simple steps. I really do hope this worked for you and that you now have a fully functional Key Fob. If so, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. But if this method didn't work for you, leave us a question in the comment section or at our community forum and we'll come up with a solution.